Okay, welcome back. Tutorial number 12 in Adobe After Effects. Today we're going to be talking about how to parent layers as well as group them. Grouping we've pretty much done in the past is where you take a composition, you can stick it in with another, and we're going to stick this composition we're going to make into the comp with that great image that we made in the background and the other one, which is this one back here. So we're going to save, we're going to make something and stick it on top of that. But before that, let's jump back to our main comp here that we're going to start. And what I have done is imported a few flower images here, as you can see. About six different ones we'll need. And what we're going to do is assemble these into an exploded cube. So we're going to bring these and drag these into comp number two here, which we're working with. And we're going to switch over. We're going to select a layer here. Select our masking slash rectangle tool. And with our layer selected, it should work as a mask. So we're going to start dragging this out. And we're going to hold down the shift key. And it's going to make a perfect square for us. So we have a perfect square. We'll say that's about the right size. And we can select this mask here. Control C to copy it. And then we can paste it here. We can Control V, paste it there. And we'll do for all of those. Now, we could do this for the photos or video or whatever you wanted to. If something wasn't small enough, you could scale down the actual image itself behind, say this first one here. You may want to try doing that before actually making your mask, though, because if we turn off all these other ones here, if we start scaling this down, it scales down the mask as well. Now, you could adjust the mask afterwards, but just know that you can do that by adjusting your mask and a bunch of different things. So we'll reset this to 100. We can turn on this layer here. We have it. Hide the scale. So let's start assembling these into an actual cube. We're going to select all our layers here. Turn them into 3D. And we're going to actually change our active camera view. It's important. And we'll start with number one here. What we're going to do is actually rename these layers. We're going to have the front of the cube, the back, the left, the right side, the top, and of course the bottom. So we have all our layers named. Now let's start assembling these. We have the front here. We're actually going to keep it where it is. We're going to hide that. And we're going to push this other one here in the back. So we're going to use our move tool. Actually hide these temporarily. And it looks like it's a bunch of images, but this is actually a... if we look at our mask and hide our mask for a minute, or even just adjust it. Expand our mask. You know, it's the original images, something along the lines of that. So it's a bunch of images in one. So don't let that fool you through this tutorial. It's just one random image I picked out. But actually move this back in the Z space just a little bit for now. So we don't know how far, we can adjust it later. Move to our left side. Now what we're going to have to do here is turn this. So left side, we'll select it. Hit W on the keyboard for our rotation tool. And we'll rotate it, hold down the shift key to unlock it into place. And we can, of course, hit V, move that to the left. We'll do the same for the right. And the top and bottom we'll adjust next. But right now we got our four pieces here. What we're going to do is jump to our different view here. We got different views that we can do from our active camera to our front. We got left, top, back, right, and bottom. We're going to jump to our top view and adjust some of the placement of these things. So what we have to do is move these things here. We have the front cube. We can use our move tool. Bring it to the front. We're going to actually expand this out a little bit. So it's not going to be butt up right against these things. We're going to have it like an exploded cube. So we're going to leave some space there. And that's that. We got our back wall. which I'm not sure why we can't see. Where is our back wall? Let's jump back to our active camera view and see where this is. Could be too far out of view that we pushed it. That could be it. Jump back to our top. And of course there it was really far back, we couldn't see it. We're gonna go off this left wall, and we'll use that as our parameter. We should have kept these left and right walls where they were, but one got pushed forward or the other one got pushed back. Either way, we'll have to adjust those. So the left wall, we're gonna keep that where it is. The right wall, I'm gonna move that on the x-axis here, sort of even that out a little bit. If we wanted to, we can get our positions and adjust these both to zero. Apparently that doesn't want to happen though, so we'll adjust it randomly. So we're going to go back about 20 on that, keep it evened out, get deselect that, and it looks about even. Now let's move them both left, select multiple layers here, move them around. And when we're happy with that, we have our all our side walls, the front, back, left, and right. Now let's move on to our top and bottom layers here. So we're going to actually view our top. We're going to actually jump into a new view. Instead of working with active camera, we'll turn off this this front layer here so we can see what we're working with too, as well as the back. Turn off the front and back. So we have our layer in the middle here, which we're going to have to rotate. Of course, it's our top. So we move this paper out of the way. We'll hit W. Got our top layer, we can rotate that, lock it into place, move it up towards the top here, and you'll notice that we're going to jump into a new view after this active camera, because we want to line this up perfectly. We don't want this any of the perspective effect going on. The perspective effect is going to mess us up with this current setup, but let's first move on to the bottom here. We'll rotate that as well. Hold down shift to lock it in place, use V on the keyboard to select our move tool once again. There we have that. So we're going to move and select our front camera view. And what this is doing is it's giving us a non-perspective type effect. So it looks like top, but it's not. We have top and or we have the front and back, which are actually hidden. But if we turn them on, we can still see the front of our image and the back of our image. But right now, we just wanted to line these up, and it looks like they're lined up fairly darn good. We did great for the perspective type effect. So let's go back, turn these two on, go back to our active camera, and these left and right walls, I want them to stick out just a little bit more, it looks like. Or is it just this front? Yeah, the front, that looks a little bit too in place. We're gonna keep it where it is because we're gonna mess with this. What I want to go over real quick though, before we go too long in this tutorial, is actually parenting. Now, if you don't have this selected, you can jump between these, but parenting allows you to group different layers, and you can adjust one, and it'll affect all of them. So we're gonna use this pick whip here, or we can use the drop down menu, and we're gonna parent all of these. So we're gonna take the bottom layer, parent to the top, take top. Parent to the right will parent to the left, the back will parent to the front, or actually no, the left will parent to the back will parent to the front. We have everything here, and you'll notice there's no parenting for the front, but if we were to adjust the rotation or position, say just the rotation, look what we can do here. We can sort of move this cube around in 3D space. And the great thing about this is maybe you had wanted to actually keyframe this to tumble around in 3D space and lock it on. So you could do this like a random tumbling cube, and for like an intro sequence of a game show, you can have it zoom in and show one contestant here, then have it tumble around and show another contestant. In fact, when I was taught this technique, my teacher was doing a project, and that's what he did. So it's a great example, I think. If you mess something up, you can right-click on the position and anything that you reset here, and put them back where they are, and you can keyframe the position. So that's one thing. Before we end this tutorial, I want to go over grouping different compositions. We said we're going to put this all in another one, so let's actually jump over to our second one here, the first one that we created. Comp 2 is our exploded square, our cube, so let's put that on top here. And of course, we have Comp 2 that we can animate through the Comp 2 layers here, maybe adjust the rotation or something. Jump back over here, and it's affected in this other composition. So we have this really great effect here, and outstanding full look in the end. So mess around with it, guys. Parenting and using the pick whips, they can be done between just layers. They can be done with effect parameters as well. So read up on the manuals and whatnot, or view tutorials online on what you can do with parenting. There's quite a bit, and it saves you a lot of time and programming in the end when it comes to animating stuff. So with that said, I'm Dave from Sonic Orb Studios. This has been After Effects tutorial number 12, parenting and grouping compositions. Until next time, I'm out of here. See you then.